This is the summary of the fatal conceit, the errors of socialism, the collected works of F. A. Hayek, by F. A. Hayek, W. W. Bartley III. Hayek gives the main arguments for the free market case and presents his manifesto on the errors of socialism. Hayek argues that socialism has, from its origins, been mistaken on factual, and even on logical, grounds and that its repeated failures in the many different practical applications of socialist ideas that this century has witnessed were the direct outcome of these errors. He labels as the fatal conceit the idea that man is able to shape the world around him according to his wishes. The achievement of the fatal conceit is that it freshly shows why socialism must be refuted rather than merely dismissed, then refutes it again. David R. Henderson, Fortune. Fascinating. The energy and precision with which Mr. Hayek sweeps away his opposition is impressive. Edward H. Crane, Wall Street Journal. F. A. Hayek is considered a pioneer in monetary theory, the preeminent proponent of the libertarian philosophy, and the ideological mentor of the Reagan and Thatcher revolutions. For more investing and business book reviews, visit www.investingbookmix.com.
Socialism assumes that all the available knowledge can be used by a single central authority. It overlooks that the modern society, which I now prefer to call the extended order, which exceeds the perception of any individual mind, is based on the utilization of widely dispersed knowledge. And once you are aware that we can achieve that great utilization of available resources only because we utilize the knowledge of millions of men, it becomes clear that the assumption of socialism that a central authority can command all this knowledge is just not correct.
So what you're doing is you're turning on its head the common point one often hears from the left, that because the problems of modern society are so difficult, that they require planning. You're saying because they're so complex, they make planning impossible.
Well, I think the nicest form to put it is to say that socialism, protesting against the production for profit and not for use, objects to what makes the extended society possible. Production for use is only possible in a society where we know all the facts. But to achieve the situation where we're all working for people whom we do not know, and are being supported by the work of people we do not know, is made possible because we produce for profit. Profit is a signal which tells us what we must do in order to serve people whom we do not know.
Yes. Now, you and von Mises put forward this criticism in the 20s. Yes. What reaction did you get from the socialists of the day? What reply did they make to that fundamental criticism?
They were unwilling to admit the factual argument. They preferred to withdraw on the pact. This is a difference of values on which science cannot decide. Once you accept the socialist values that we must be guided by a conception of just distribution, all the factual arguments are irrelevant. Well, of course, the factual arguments prove that the just distribution is impossible unless the distributor knows all the facts. So my answer is, if the factual assumption of socialism were correct, it would be a moral duty to aim at the just distribution. But you have to recognize you cannot do it. In fact, you can produce enough as to maintain the present population of the world only because of a spontaneous process or mechanism which enables you to make use of infinitely more information than any central authority possesses.
个要讲的呢是过度自信，跟刚才陈老师讲第一个呢那个控制幻觉呢有异曲同工之妙。那所以呢点下那个例子部分的话，我会帮大家做一下搭配。那过度自信呢，先讲个平常大家都遇到的例子，或者是实验是这样做的，就是呢如果就是问所有的驾驶人说呢，请问一下你觉得你自己的那个开车技术怎么样，基本上应该是这样子，应该是如果是有平均值的话，应该是或三分之一的人觉得他的驾驶技术优于一般人嘛，然后应该会有三分之一的人呢觉得他的开车技术平就是跟大部分人差不多，然后或者三分之一的人觉得自己的开车技术比一般人差。但是发现呢结果并不是这样子，发现呢就是所有的驾驶人呢有82%的人觉得他的开车技术呢优于一般人。所以代表什么？大部分人都是过度自信的，就是觉得自己的能力都比别人强。还有像说呢讲创业其实要成功其实不容易嘛，那所有要创业的人呢基本上都会觉得自己会创业成功，因为不会有人一开始就觉得我自己创业会失败嘛，所以所有人都想要创业成功。那自己在评估自己是创业能不能成功呢，大概70%的人都觉得我这样子已经做好所有的安排跟准备了，人事啊钱啊，然后这个产业感觉应该是非常有前景，这应该是很重要的缺口，我来做这个部分一定会赚钱，反正70%的人都觉得他会成功。可是呢他看别人创业的时候就说，哎，那个你好像有个朋友也要创业，你觉得他成功的几率怎么样？我看他大概成功几率只有40%而已，所以看自己那个创业的人都觉得会成功的几率比较高，可是看别人都觉得别人好像没有这么厉害。所以过度自信很常会发生在自己身上，我们看自己通常比较不准，我们看别人通常都是比较准的，就是预估对方就是未来发展怎么样都是比较准的。所以呢我们星期四的上课用书讲再想一下嘛，它里面也有讲到一个例子，他讲说大学生毕业的时候呢大家都想说之后未来到底自己的前途是能一片光明，那所有的毕业生大部分人都觉得我自己毕业之后通常都是一定是赚钱赚最多，然后最快能买到第一栋房子，然后最快存到人生第一桶金，最快可以结婚生子，然后呢未来光明一片前途，就是前途一片光明。但是通常看其他人呢，他就说隔壁同学他那么混，大学的时候上课也不去上，然后也没什么专长，他老板要雇佣他这种人，通常我觉得他未来岌岌可危，通常看别人都是很准，可看自己通常都不准，都觉得自己应该是很厉害的。其实这生活当中很多啦，比如说考高不好也是，很多人就觉得他自己考高不好应该就是会上，为什么呢？他即使知道录取率只有1%，大部分人考高不好是不知道录取率多少的，可是即使知道到底录取率实际的数据是多少，成功几率很低，但是他就会说虽然高考成功几率很低但是完全不适合我，我就是会考上的那一个，对自己非常有自信，成功几率很低那个不适合我。所以大部分人都觉得他自己不是一般人，因为在投资上面也是这样啊。周行一教授有这本书，他就讲说台湾股民就是投资人大概90%都赔钱，但大部分人都觉得我不是一般人，我投资应该是不会赔钱，或者赔钱都是身旁那些人，或是呢觉得自己选股能力很厉害，就是觉得自己选股能力跟巴菲特一样，然后选股能力很准，所以对自己非常有自信，这是过度自信的来源。